So, you have half a walking animation, but you feel like there should be an easy way to finish the other half. And you would be correct. In the next 20 seconds, you will know how to flip and mirror any animation you could possibly think of. And if you stick around, you'll have a complete walking cycle as well. Alright, let's do this. Click the record button, decide how long you want the animation to be. I'm just gonna say 30 frames. Scrub to the start frame, drag select all the bones, press I to key, lock, rot, and scale. Control C to copy the frame and scrub to the end of the cycle and Control V to paste it. Now in the middle, we need to reverse our animation. To do that, scrub to a keyframe, drag select all the bones and unselect the hands. You can do this by holding shift and drag selecting them. Control C to copy and go to the middle and click key and select paste flipped. You can also use shift Control V. And now you can see that we have pasted the mirrored version of our original animation. If you did not unselect the hands, you're gonna get this weird finger bending movement, so make sure that you do not select the hands when doing this. Alright, so we have the beginning, middle, and end of our walking cycle, but we can make it look better. Go to the middle frame that you just pasted, drag select all the bones, press I to key, lock, rot, and scale, Control C to copy them, scrub a little bit to the left, and then press Control V to paste it again, and make this frame a little bit more exaggerated than the middle. So drag the bottom down a tiny bit, and make small adjustments to the arms and head. Nothing crazy, just a bit of weight. When you're done, drag select the bones, press I to keyframe, lock, rot, and scale, and now scrub to the 25% area, and again, press I here to keyframe, lock, rot, and scale. Now, we need to make the up motion of taking a step. So grab the base and move it a bit up, tilt the head down to compensate, start to move the arms where they should be heading, and then lift the forward leg into the air, and aim the foot down just a bit. Alright, looks pretty good. Now there's one last thing that you should do, and that is go between that frame and the one next to it here, and just tilt the foot up just a bit. In my opinion, it just helps the step look a little bit more real. Okay, now drag select all the bones except for the hands, drag select the frames between the middle and the beginning, Control C to copy them, scrub to the 75% area, and shift Control V to paste them flipped. You're done. And now you have completed a walking animation. Feel free to change the spacing of the frames for fine-tuning if you need. Hope that helps. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you around.